We're getting married.
I would rather die than watch her marry Jason.
I know exactly what you did to my father.
Hello?
It's Freddie.
Cheers.
When I'm with him, I'm thinking about Robbie. And when I'm with Robbie, I'm thinking about Jason.
Maxine, you're going to get what you deserve.
Patrick, too much for me, Darren. It's too much for me.
He knows. And he gets to me. He gets to you too.
You know, you really have an artist's touch. For a moment, you were just Trevor.
She said, tell me, am I marrying the right brother?
Why did you adopt me? You've always hated me.
Darren, if you don't tell me the truth, I'm going to go to Maxine and get it out of her.
No.
If I don't, the police will. Did you really believe you could keep it a secret?
No, Marty, don't do this.
It's you.
I'm just like everyone else. I want to know who the killer is.
Listen carefully, for I am about to reveal a terrifying secret, one that will chill you to your very crunker sticks. That's Evan Morian for Bones, by the way. Last night, Jake and I were getting ready for bed when we heard a strange sound outside the manor. Jake said he thought it was a snoot calling, but it was clearly something much more dangerous. But was it a moor troll or a zombog? I had to find out, so I investigated. With these precision apparition vision prisms. And then I saw it. Most people would have mistaken the monster for a mere rabbit. But I knew it was an ancient bog banshee with 12 sets of teeth, a withered face, and a cry that could stop your heart at 50 paces. Most people would have fainted on the spot, but my supernatural quest wasn't over. When I crept back to my room, there was a supernatural smell in the air. And someone, or something, had eaten my last cookie. Jake was in here the whole time, but he didn't see anything. He kept saying there was nothing to worry about. That boy just can't handle the truth. Because bogvine cookies were Aunt Bridget's second favourite biscuits. And everyone says that Aunt Bridget died. But did she? Yes, but does that mean she's gone for good? I don't think so.
Hi, Mum. It's me, again. Just please call me back, okay?
Mum! Mum! You will never make me understand why, okay? Just stop calling me.
Look, if I knew you were out there somewhere, I would have come looking for you.
Me too.
How could our parents do this to us?
Glad I never asked you out.
Well, my mum's a screw-up.
No, she's not the only one that didn't want me. My adoptive mum didn't want to know. My dad's clearly too ashamed of me to tell me I was his.
Alfie.
I just don't know who I am anymore.
Holly, what are you doing out here? It's your turn. Come on, chop chop.
Emily Bronte organised Wuthering Heights in a way where history repeated itself. Was about the destruction of a love that never changed. Just when in cycles of the horrors of the past repeating themselves in the present.
I need to see my door.
Not here.
Holly, not now.
Right, everyone, I have a family emergency, so can you all make your way to the common room and Mrs. Peterson will take over.
Thank you. Cindy, you need to go too.
Yeah, sorry.
What are you trying to do to me?
Get you to hear why I had to give up my baby.
Found it. Right, get on there.
I'm really not sure about this.
Come on, let Grace work her magic.
Yeah, let's make sure everything's okay.
Right. Just lift your top up. Well, don't prod me.
We'll keep still then.
When should we hear something?
Really, these things, unless they're used right, I mean, it's tough to hear a heartbeat the best of times.
Well, why don't we go to the hospital then and get an ultrasound?
It's too early, I told you that.
Right, I'll do it then.
She is the nurse.
I did the rotation on a maternity ward. Got taught how to use the ultrasounds and everything. The sonographer took a bit of a shine to me, if you know what I mean. Took me in there late at night. Can you believe the way people behave? You know, sneaking around hospitals. Takes all sorts, I suppose. Normally find these in a heartbeat. Strange.
Is that it? Is that the baby?